attempted murder in California. He's also accused of human trafficking here in Lee County involving a 15-year-old girl. Thank you for counting on NBC2. I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Kyla Gaylor. Aldo's brother says he has waited 7 years just to find out any new information about his brother's case. NBC2's Hope Salmon spoke to him tonight.
We want the person responsible for this to pay for their crime.
Calvin Baez has waited 7 years for justice. But tonight, deputies say they now know who killed his half-brother, Aldo Camillo.
It was really devastating to know that he lost his life in that kind of way. I'm happy that they got someone and you know, they've never stopped working on the case.
Baez says there isn't a day that goes by that he doesn't think of his brother and hope that the person who took his life is punished.
It's really important to make sure that, you know, this person never sees the light of day.
Here's what happened in 2015. Authorities say they were responding to a call about a car on fire in Lehigh Acres. It wasn't until later that they found Camillo's body inside the car.
My brother had the biggest smile in the room. He wanted to be a football player growing up. The last conversation I had with him was him telling me that he was proud of what I was doing with my life.
Tonight, investigators say Sonny Rashad Jabari is the person who took Aldo's life. Jabari is also accused of sex trafficking a 15-year-old girl. They believe that's how Jabari set up Camillo in 2015 before he robbed and killed him. Though detectives believe Camillo went there after seeing an ad on an adult classified site called Backpage.
I was in front of my boss and I broke down crying in tears, like screaming hysterically, making sure that he serves the rest of his life in jail, that would give us 100% comfort and peace and happiness. I'd be lying if I said that was true. I believe it was a situation where, again, he didn't know what he was necessarily walking into, and he was caught in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Detectives say witness statements are what helped lead to Jabari's arrest.
It won't bring my brother back, and it won't give us the closure that we need to, like, really know what happened.
Baez has moved to Florida, and he's hoping to help raise Aldo's daughter. In studio, Hope Salmon, NBC2.
The fire chief and 40 of his 46 firefighters are resigning on Upper Captiva. They'll all be gone in a few weeks.
Our team spoke with John Trujillo this evening. He's the division chief of EMS and training, and he says the island was planning to cut firefighting staff, which means it could be unsafe for the ones who are still there.
The more people you have, the safer it is for a command staff on scene and for the guys that